The temporomandibular joint, or TMJ, connects the temporal bone of the cranium to the condyle of the mandible. An articulating disc is in between the condyle of the mandible and the mandibular fossa of the temporal bone. It aims to create smooth movement, distribute pressure, and maintains the synovial fluid. A capsule covers the TMJ and aims to limit movements and prevent dislocation. Temporomandibular disorder, or TMD, is an umbrella term for disorders causing pain and dysfunction in the temporomandibular region. It includes issues with alignment or synchronization, which generally affects chewing. Key features include orofacial pain, restricted jaw function, and joint noises. Other common features include headaches, blocked ears, masseter hypertrophy, and muscle tenderness. TMD affects all genders and ages, but is more common in women aged 20 to 40. Factors like jaw injury, bruxism, arthritis, and psychosocial stress increase TMD risk. Sometimes TMD is also idiopathic, meaning that it has an unknown cause. TMD falls into four major categories: muscle only, hypermobility, inflammation, and disc derangement. Muscle-only problems result from muscle overuse or damage, causing local myalgia. There is also centrally mediated myalgia, which is caused by damage to motor neurons. This usually results in myofascial pain, which is often triggered by bruxism, where there is grinding of the teeth, or as a result of a malocclusion, where the upper and lower teeth do not bite appropriately. TMJ hypermobility occurs when the ligaments are loose, and the condyle can move beyond the articular eminence. This leads to clicking, popping noises, and open lock situations. Inflammation can be primary, caused by systemic conditions like rheumatoid arthritis, or secondary, due to external factors like trauma to the TMJ itself, resulting in constant pain and limited jaw movement. TMJ disc derangement has four subtypes. First is a deviation in anatomy, where there are anatomical abnormalities in the condyle, articular eminence, or the disc itself. The second is disc displacement without locking, where the disc is out of place, causing a clicking sound during jaw movement. This happens due to a loose collateral ligament and hypermobility as previously discussed. Third is disc displacement with locking, where once again the disc is out of place, but in this case, the jaw can get locked in either an open or a closed position. And then the fourth subtype is the degeneration of the TMJ, where the disc has a tear or is displaced for a long period of time, which leads to osteoarthritis, as the condyle and articular eminence are in closer contact. TMD is diagnosed through a comprehensive medical examination, dental history, physical examination, which includes palpating the TMJ and the surrounding structures, as well as assessing mouth opening and imaging techniques like MRI, CT, or cone beam CT scans. Sometimes a specialist referral may be required to obtain an accurate diagnosis of the condition and its underlying etiology. Treatment depends on severity and underlying causes, but generally there are three main approaches. Approach number one is self-care interventions, which include resting the jaw, using hot or cold packs, eating soft foods, and stress management. Approach number two is conservative treatments, and this includes over-the-counter non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen, muscle relaxants, mouth guards or splints, and physical therapy. And approach number three is advanced interventions, which includes injecting medications into trigger points or surgical management, which is more rare. To summarize, TMD encompasses a range of conditions, causing pain and dysfunction in the TMJ and surrounding tissues. It presents with various symptoms and has multifactorial causes. Diagnosis involves a thorough evaluation, and treatment varies based on individual needs. Proper management involves self-care and conservative management first, followed by more advanced interventions for more advanced conditions. Appropriate management can significantly improve the quality of life for those affected by TMD.